things have a life cycle, including spacecraft. They are conceived in a science hub, meticulously designed and constructed by engineers to ensure their successful mission in space. Every aspect, down to the smallest screw and tool, is carefully planned. Unfortunately, some spacecraft face premature deaths before their completion, while others meet their end on the launch pad. Many spend months or years in space fulfilling their intended mission until it reaches its conclusion. Then there are the exceptional cases, like the Voyager probes, whose missions have been extended well beyond their initial purpose by over 46 years. Similar to elderly individuals nearing the end of their lives, it is understandable that Voyager 1 is now encountering issues after its extensive time in space. But what's causing these issues? And is it going to lead to the end of the mission? Keep watching the video to get to know more about it. The glitch. So, in a nutshell, NASA's Voyager 1 probe is experiencing a computer glitch. The consequence of that? A bit of a communication breakdown between the probe and the mission team on Earth. Let's be a little clearer. In case you didn't know, the probe is currently the farthest spacecraft from Earth. It's actually found at about 15 billion miles or 24 billion kilometers away. The mission team is on Earth in Pasadena. Any type of signal to the spacecraft has to travel this enormous distance and reach the spacecraft that, being this far, is nothing more than a tiny little dot in a sky filled with stars. Also, Voyager 2 is very far, 12 billion miles away from us, or 20 billion kilometers. Both probes are in what is known as interstellar space and are the only spacecraft ever to operate beyond the heliosphere, the sun's bubble of magnetic fields and particles that extends well beyond the orbit of the planet, the dwarf planet Pluto. To better understand what the Voyager 1 glitch is about, it's crucial to know that the Voyager 1 sends pieces of binary code to Earth, meaning a long series of zeros and ones, mixed so as to be translated into human-readable information. The zeros and ones contain all kinds of information about the mission status and scientific experiments. Data on cosmic rays detection, magnetic field measurements, or even plasma waves. Everything is contained in these number sequences. What scientists recently realized is that something is wrong with the Flight Data System's telecommunications unit, because it's sending out a repeating, nonsensical pattern. Voyager 1 seems therefore trapped in a loop, and the scientists are unable to decipher the code sent. But also, it would not take much sense to decipher it, as it clearly does not contain any scientific information. With the probe glitched, no science experiment can be performed. Although scientists expect the probes to suffer from this kind of problem at this stage of the mission, they're already working hard to understand what's causing it, and different possible solutions are being considered. To start off, the Voyager team sent commands to the spacecraft over the past weekend to restart the flight data system. In fact, a message sent from Voyager took more than 22 hours to reach Earth, and the team had to wait another 45 hours to receive a response. And what they found out was that they did not succeed. Now, the team anticipated that it could take several more weeks to develop a new plan to address the problem. However, both probes are now over 40 years out of date, so finding solutions to problems often requires engineers and technical experts to consult the original documents. These decades-old documents were created by engineers who didn't anticipate the problems the probes are encountering today. As a result, it takes the mission team time to determine how a new command will affect the spacecraft's operations and how to avoid unintended consequences. Other problems and solutions. Voyager 1 has previously sent strange messages, including in May of 2022 when NASA engineers received incorrect telemetry data. The Attitude Articulation and Control System, AACS, responsible for maintaining the spacecraft's antenna aligned with Earth for communication, provided inaccurate information about its orientation and position in space. Although the AACS appeared to be functioning normally, the data it transmitted was considered unreliable as it did not correspond to any possible system state. However, engineers managed to resolve the issue after identifying the source of the problem. It was discovered that a defunct computer, which should not have been used to transmit telemetry data, was unexpectedly operational and had been corrupting the information. This incident provides a valuable lesson for future endeavors. Other general issues that arose over time are, for instance, failing instruments and limited maneuverability. The failure of instruments is a natural consequence of the harsh space environment and the extended duration of the mission. Moreover, some instruments were purposely turned off in order to save energy and make the mission last longer. Concerning the maneuverability issues, the Voyager probes were not designed with the capability for major course adjustments. They follow a trajectory set during their planetary flybys, and their orientation is fixed, limiting their ability to reposition for new observations. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve it for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. The Voyager mission so far. For those of you who are not really familiar with the Voyager probes, or if you just need to refresh your memory, here's a brief mission overview. Both probes were launched in 1977. This was a special year. A rare alignment of the outer planets would allow scientists to take a grand tour of the solar system. Little did they know this would change our understanding of the universe forever. Voyager 2 made its mark as the first spacecraft to visit Uranus and Neptune, revealing their unique atmospheres and diverse moons. Just to understand the importance of such a mission, Voyager 2 discovered a large, previously unseen dark storm system on Neptune, known as the Great Dark Spot. This feature, similar to Jupiter's Great Red Spot, was an unexpected find. Subsequent observations, including those from the Hubble Space Telescope, revealed that the Great Dark Spot is dynamic and can appear and disappear over time. Regarding Jupiter, Voyager made a groundbreaking discovery by observing active volcanoes on one of its moons, Io. This marked the first time that active volcanoes were detected on another celestial body in our solar system. During the Voyager missions, a total of 9 volcanic eruptions on Io were witnessed, with indications of additional eruptions occurring in between the encounters. Interestingly, it seems that the volcanic activity on Io has a significant impact on the entire Jovian system. The volcanoes on Io release sulfur, oxygen, and sodium, which are then propelled off the moon's surface by the impact of high-energy particles. These volcanic materials have been detected even at the outermost edge of Jupiter's magnetosphere, millions of miles away from the planet itself. Essentially, Io functions as an electrical generator as it moves through Jupiter's magnetic field. This movement generates a potential difference of 400,000 volts across Io's diameter, resulting in an electric current of 3 million amps that flows along the planet's magnetic field in the ionosphere. Shifting our focus to Uranus, Voyager discovered 10 previously unknown moons, increasing the total number to 5 times its original count. This signifies a remarkable 200% increase in the number of moons orbiting Uranus. Among these new moons, Miranda stands out as an extraordinarily peculiar celestial body. Detailed images have revealed its vast fault canyons reaching depths of up to 12 miles or 20 kilometers, as well as its layered structure consisting of both old and young surfaces. One theory suggests that Miranda might have formed through the reaggregation of material following a violent impact that fractured the moon in an earlier period. Each Voyager probe carried a time capsule containing a golden record filled with sounds and images representing human culture. It was intended as a message to potential extraterrestrial civilizations in the future. However, the mission went beyond the boundaries of the solar system. Voyager 1 in particular continued its journey into interstellar space, becoming the farthest human-made object from Earth. The engineers on Earth faced challenges, but they persisted. During their journey through the solar system, the Voyagers were reprogrammed remotely to enhance their capabilities. Their original 2-planet mission expanded to 4, and their projected 5-year lifespan exceeded 12 years and more. When Voyager 1 crossed the heliopause, the boundary between the solar wind and the interstellar medium, scientists discovered that the magnetic field in interstellar space was stronger and more complex than expected. This finding challenged existing models of the solar wind and its interaction with the surrounding interstellar medium. According to NASA, even if the Voyager mission had ended after the flybys of Jupiter and Saturn, it would have already made significant contributions to astronomy. However, the Voyagers went above and beyond, gathering information that revolutionized the science of planetary astronomy. They help resolve key questions while also raising intriguing new ones about the origins and evolutions of the planets in our solar system. The Voyagers have also transformed into observatories that focus on detecting ultraviolet radiation in space. Their unique position in the universe offers astronomers the most advantageous perspective to study celestial objects emitting this type of radiation. Among the instruments on the scan platform, the ultraviolet spectrometer, UVS, remains functional. The scan platform is currently stationed in a fixed position and does not have any articulation. To preserve power, the infrared spectrometer and radiometer, IRIS, heater was deactivated on Voyager 1 on December 7, 2011. On January 21, 2014, the scan platform supplemental heater was also turned off for power conservation purposes. The IRIS heater and the scan platform heater were responsible for maintaining the UVS at an appropriate temperature. Although the UVS temperature has now dropped below the limit of sensor measurements, it continues to operate. There are several other fields and particle instruments that can keep transmitting data as long as the spacecraft remains functional. These include the cosmic ray subsystem, the low energy charge particle instrument, the magnetometer, the plasma subsystem, the plasma wave subsystem, and the planetary radio astronomy instrument. So let's hope everything goes well, and stay tuned for more updates on the glitch issue. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. As we conclude this journey, feel free to share your thoughts on this video in the comments below. Do you think we will be able to save Voyager 1 once again? We'll see you next time on the channel.